to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said, what's broke to a guy with a mask? What's both to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like, let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain, pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
For the wins, came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gonna jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gonna pray for me.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Tennessee Titans. The kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Now a first carry for Derek Henry. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. It's rare that a man his size can't at least push forward for a yard, but they stopped him there for nothing.
You're talking about Tiny? You're talking about the little guy back Tiny. There? That monster. Yeah, you're exactly right. And it takes a group effort to get a guy like that down and not let him find some space. The first guy in, he's got to take one for the team, right? Because he's just waiting there and holding on for everyone else to help him out.
Here's second and 10. A toss right to Henry. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance in guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens up.
Derrick Henry!
In your face!
Touchdown, Titans!
Derrick Henry!
73 yards! And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. The underdog here is showing no fear. Great opening drive.
Now, we weren't in the locker room for the pregame speech, but I will guarantee you, somewhere along the way, the head coach said, let's just grab a big stick and smack them with it and let them know we're going to be here today. They may be the team that's supposed to be superior, but we're not backing down to anyone.
And on the road, no less, setting the tone. Now, Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 22. The first carry down, this is Alvin Kamara.
Number 40,
Daquan Jones in on the tackle there.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 15 yards on the play, first down. So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45.
Alvin Kamara.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5 at the 45.
On second down, Kamara. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line.
Kamara. He was brought down by Vic Beasley. It's a gain of 3. Brings up third and 2.
Breeze looking to throw on third and 2. And he finds Cook. There he goes, left side.
Right down here.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Jared Cook, 53 yards. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. That's pretty impressive, Charles. It's one thing to be an elite speed wide receiver and have all that yards after the catch into the end zone, but from your tight end?
Yeah, you don't get that very often. What you're describing is more like a Tyreek Hill, a Davante Adams, and Antonio Brown. You're not talking about a guy that lines up or can line up in line and look like an extra tackle on running plays. He took that bad boy downfield just like he was a scat back.
Before the game, he told me, I'm going to have a zinger or two today. And I was like, oh, a zinger or two? I guess that's a zinger, right?
That's a zinger.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light there. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get an advantage that way.
And yeah, nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Janoris.
Tackled by Janoris Jenkins.
No gain on the play. Second.
On second down, here's Tannehill. He completes it to Henry. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And they're left looking at 3rd and 8 after the second down pass play only went for 2. They'll toss it to Henry. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A loss of a yard and it brings up 4th.
A loss of a yard brings up 4th down.
These two teams all tied after 1. Tough ask here. They're going to go for it on 4th down and 9. They are going for it. It's Tannehill. He's got a man, Corey Davis. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the 4th down attempt and keeping the drive alive? A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up 1st and 10. A toss left, Henry. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
On second down now, it's Henry. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. And that is incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Tannehill staying out there. They're going to go on fourth down. They're going to go. It's Tannehill. Uncorks one for Davis. And this is going to be incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And that will force a turnover on downs.
It's a big one now.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
The coaches stressed their defense being physical. They don't just mean the big guys. How about the guys on the outside, the cornerbacks? It's not just their job to patrol the airspace. They can get involved in the run game as well.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's seven. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Second and 11 now. Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. Alvin Kamara. 31 yards. And the Saints have taken the lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right because you really need the rush. Almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, wherever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Taken about 7 yards deep. Got some space here. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And the Titans are in for six. Touchdown.
And as we've talked to special teams coaches, that theme of being aggressive continues to come through, doesn't it? When they moved the kickoff back to the 35, it was going to cut down on the number of opportunities. But if you've got a special guy, you give him the green light no matter where he fields in the end zone. And in this case, it paid off handsomely.
He fielded it deep in the range of emotions. Maybe like, oh, no, don't. And then all of a sudden you see him break it. And you're like, yeah, way to go.
Yeah, sometimes you have to remind your head coach that he approved the green light for bringing it out from deep in the end zone, and that's exactly why he did.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in.
And he fires one, it's intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
First and 10.
Now, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 44. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Second and 10. At the
second and 10. Derrick Henry. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 23 yards the pick up there.
I remember watching Derrick Henry come out of Alabama and sitting with some scouts, and one of the debate points with him was, while at Bama, how often did he have to deal with contact near the line of scrimmage? They were so good up front that he often got to the second level pretty easily. I think he's starting to answer those questions with runs like that. He's a physical, physical guy.
7-yard pickup.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. This is Henry. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down, 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
First and 10. At their own 20-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect. But overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Bree's going to try and throw on 3rd down. Open man is Michael Thomas. He's at the 30. Pass the 20. Saints have moved out in front. It was 3rd and medium. They popped the short pass, looking to pick up the first, accomplish that mission, and then they accomplished a lot more on that mission all the way for the score.
Let me focus in on one word you used, pop, right? They popped the short pass, and then what happened after that? They popped the big run, because now, once he caught it, didn't have anyone else in the vicinity to bring him down, and he takes off, and he kept going. Nice gutsy call, even better execution.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. From the gun, here's Tannehill. The open man is Smith. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first. Looking here for Smith downfield. And a double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They'll try to get the offense going with Kamara. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10.
The ball carrier.
5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Again, it's Kamara. And a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a 3rd down. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And they're going to get the 1st down here as he's up to the 14. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Breeze now on 1st down. And that's complete to Sanders. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
19-yard line.
He'll get about 3 to the 21.
Kamara.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
They run it again with Kamara. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Just 1 yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down.
Don't forget knowing where the 1st down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front, and a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
The Saints do snap it. It's Breeze. Shift in momentum here in the 4th quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets them to 2nd and 4. From the 17, here's 2nd and 4.
2nd and 4.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a 4th down. They'll run for it with
he close? Did he get there? No, they're going to say he shortened the line to gain. Derrick Henry denied here on fourth down. And the Saints will have the football back.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. No run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. Looks like he's going to be stopped short of the first down by about a yard. Call it a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Now, we might start getting some props here in the booth. You know, that one that says the D and then the fence that you put up next to it. How about that? They brought out the jumbo package and still couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage enough to pick up that first down.
Impressive. They were ready defensively for that jumbo set. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. A solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. And this will go for five up to the 33. Well, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right. But the problem for them is still within a possession. So they can't just sit on it running the ball. They have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. Trying to run down some clock with Kamara. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
A gain of two.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave them with a third and about four more for a first. This will be play number nine of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Breeze. And brought in by the tight end corner. The 35 will be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. That one a backbreaker as they wind up converting there on fourth. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On the ground, this is Kamara. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
A loss of a yard.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what
reason. Emmanuel Sanders! And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away.